I'm Carrie Ann Jones, the Assistant Secretary of State for Oceans, International Environmental and Scientific Affairs. I'd like to welcome you here today for the signing of this environmental cooperation agreement between the Government of the Republic of Korea and the Government of the United States of America. For more than 60 years, our nations have worked together. We cooperate on a host of issues that include security, clean energy, and environment. For example, in October 2011, we established the U.S.-Korea Clean Energy Technology Partnership that will strengthen our bilateral cooperation in clean energy technology research and development. The agreement we are signing today, together with the environmental provisions in the U.S.-Korea Free Trade Agreement, cements our environmental partnership and provides the framework to expand the partnership in the future. We are honored to have two distinguished representatives of our governments here to sign this agreement. Robert Hormats is the Undersecretary of State for Economic Growth, Energy, and the Environment. Undersecretary Hormats has a distinguished career in the United States government and in the private sector. He has served as the Vice Chairman of Goldman Sachs International, Assistant Secretary of State for Economic and Business Affairs, Ambassador and Deputy U.S. Trade Representative, and Senior Deputy Assistant Secretary for Economic and Business Affairs at the Department of State. Han Duck-soo is Korea's Ambassador to the United States. Previously, Ambassador Han was the Prime Minister of the Republic of Korea, Minister of Trade, Ambassador to the OECD, President of the Korea Institute for Industrial Economics and Trade, and Chairman of the Presidential Committee on Facilitating our new Free Trade Agreement. We are very pleased to have such illustrious representatives of their countries here to sign this important agreement. I'll now turn the podium over to Undersecretary Hormats.
Thank you very much, Carrie Ann, and I want to thank you and all of your colleagues and OES who worked so hard on this agreement, and I know it took a great deal of work on the part of you and all of your colleagues. I'm also particularly honored to be here with my friend for many years, Ambassador Han, who is, as you know, a real leader in developing close relations between the United States and Korea, but also a man of a great global reputation for his vision, his leadership, and the enormous amount of work he's done to strengthen the Korean economy and strengthen Korea's role in the global economy. So I'm particularly honored to be on the podium with you, Mr. Ambassador. I also want to thank other distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, who have joined us here today, and welcome you all to the State Department. And this is a room that we use for very special occasions. You can see the picture of our first Secretary of State looking out on us, and I'm sure he'd be very proud of what we're doing here today. Let me begin by thanking all the participants for joining us in the signing of the Environmental Cooperation Agreement between the United States and the Republic of Korea. I want to particularly thank all the Koreans who've come here who've played a very active role in this. I've had a long-standing relationship with Korea, as Ambassador Han knows. I've been to Korea and had the pleasure of visiting many times, so we're particularly honored that all of you would join us here this morning. Our two governments have a deeply rooted partnership which has endured over decades, and this has been many decades where we have work together on a wide range of issues. Our alliance, as Secretary Clinton has noted, is a symbol of security, stability, peace, and prosperity. The Environmental Cooperation Agreement will further strengthen the partnership between our two countries. Together, we can combat illegal logging and trade in wildlife, reduce air and water pollution, increase the use of environmentally friendly materials and the recycling of waste, and implement measures to ensure that our transportation sectors, our cars, our airplanes, and our ships meet very high environmental standards. The Environmental Cooperation Agreement was negotiated in parallel with the U.S.-Korea Free Trade Agreement, CORUS, which President Obama noted as having groundbreaking projections for the environment during the President's October visit to the United States. It has in it the protections for the environment, which both of our countries are committed to, and these environmental protections are very much a part of a broader set of economic and environmental cooperative relations between our two countries. The two texts reference one another, which combined will orient the United States and Korea to lead the world as we both transition in a robust way to a global economy. And both of our leaders are committed to doing this, and I think they're committed, as this indicates, to working together to do it in a cooperative way. This transition has the potential to grow our economies and create millions of jobs. But it will not be easy. 9 out of 10 units of energy that we consume today are produced by hydrocarbons, which include coal, oil, and natural gas. The United States and Korea, along with the broader global community, must work together to include the environment as a variable in our economic calculus. And we in the United States have been making the point regularly, and Carrie Ann and I have been working together particularly closely on this, to demonstrate that good business policy and good environmental policy can be, and indeed are, the same. That is to say that you can improve profitability and improve the business outlook for your companies and for your economy by engaging in good, sound environmental practices. And the two are not mutually exclusive, they're mutually supportive. And I think this is one of the very key elements that we think are very important to emphasize as we move forward in our country and indeed in all countries. Despite the obstacles ahead, I have high hopes because our nations have repeatedly exceeded expectations in this area over the last 50 years. Recall that Korea grew from nominal per capita GDP of approximately $100 in 1962 to almost $21,000 in 2010. Improvements in labor productivity were a key component of our economic growth in the 20th century. The management of natural resources, the environment, will define our success in the 21st century and how we utilize our natural resources for the benefit of our people and to improve the outlook for our economies. At our present level of resource productivity, our planet can feed and accommodate some 1.5 million people at the OECD country standard of living. 1.5 billion people at the OECD country standard of living. The world today has 7 billion people. There is an obvious gap, which is why we need new ideas and new solutions to raise standards of living around the world in a way that's sustainable, as well as change the way we ourselves live. The U.S.-Korea Environmental Cooperation Agreement moves us toward that reality. Before I turn the floor over to my friend Ambassador Han, I will also note that we are cooperating with the Republic of Korea on another environmental venture this summer. The United States will host a pavilion at the 2012 Yeosu World Expo, which will have an environmental theme, which is living oceans and coast. The U.S. pavilion will showcase our diversity, our values, and demonstrate that the innovation and creativity of American companies is a very dynamic part of our economy, and we want to share that dynamism with other countries as well. The pavilion will highlight how we can work collaboratively to solve our common global environmental challenges. We hope that today's event serves as a reminder of the strong and important relationship between our two countries and our common desire to address environmental issues in a cooperative and mutually supportive way. So I'm very pleased to be a part of this overall process of cooperation and collaboration. I think this is an historic achievement between our two countries, and it demonstrates that our two countries are working together to promote leadership in this very important area. We hope to continue to do that and to demonstrate to other countries around the world that the U.S. and Korea working together can be leaders and can set a trend, which we hope other countries also will follow in a wide range of environmental areas. So it is my great honor and my great privilege to introduce my very good, longstanding friend, Ambassador Han.
Good morning. I think this morning is a very meaningful time for us to reaffirm again the real cooperation between the United States and Korea based on common values. In June 2009, when my President Lee Myung-bak visited here to Washington, he and President Obama signed a joint vision for the future alliance and partnership of the United States and Korea in the future. They emphasized not only the traditional military alliances, which is very crucial, they affirmed that they will diversify the scope of the alliance and partnership into other areas which had not been so much well taken advantage of. That was economics, and that was also the environments. They promised that environmental protection and low carbon green growth will be the momentum for the future prosperity of Korea and the United States. We have had experience of more than decades of cooperation in the area of environmental protections in research and developments and smart grid areas. But I think the agreements we will sign today with respectable Secretary Hormats will be the real framework agreements on what we have been doing up to now. And that will also be a stimulus in implementing our very well-defined provisions in our historic Korea-U.S. Free Trade Agreements. Free Trade Agreements should be always combined with more jobs and higher level of standards for environmental protection and labor standards. And those are exactly what have been tried and quite scrupulously written in our agreements of FTA. So these agreements we will sign today will be a basis for the efforts that we will conduct in the future for making the prosperity and joint alliance and joint partnership possible between the United States and Korea. So I really would like to thank all the staffs of the State Departments and corresponding staffs of Korean government for their efforts in making these agreements possible, and we will in the future will very faithfully implement these agreements so that our efforts on our commitments to common values will be the norm of our cooperations in the future. Thank you. Thank you very much.
We will now have the signing of the agreement.